Hello and welcome to Naples Napalm, where today we have just won our major war for independence and for Sicily, and now we need to get things stable and balanced out. So, let's choose our rivals. Let's take Aragon, of course, because we probably are going to supersede them pretty soon when they get inevitably torn apart by Austria. Maybe he'll give some land to Catalonia, that would be nice. And I do want to choose the Papal State, but let's save that for a little bit. And then what else do we need to do? We need to figure out our budget. So at the moment, we are not paying for our army, which we do want to reinforce. It's only about 800 manpower behind, but we do want to raise this up a little bit. We are making plenty of money, so let's raise it up to half about. Let's raise it up there. There we go, about 1/4. And we can take our administrative tech. I don't believe there's any reason to wait, really. I mean, this is 2%, it's not worth waiting for. However, we are getting institution spread pretty strong, as that is our national idea. Institution spread plus 10%. And in our main province of Napoli, our capital, it is, where is it? Oh man, I'm getting lost in all these new tabs. Anyway, Renaissance right here, 0.46 per month. That is from being an Italian capital, 20 development, and 10 province development. Oh, well, they're both from having 20 development, but you get the point. Anyway, so let's go and, yes, absolutely, we will marry you. And we are going to want to assign one of our diplomats. That's in the diplomatic macro builder. Like I said, learning this soon, as we speak, so not exactly the most adept at figuring out the new mechanics just yet, but it'll come with time. Let's let time go by, and now that we're securely friends with France, let's choose the Papal State and hope that they don't break their alliance with us. I don't believe they will. Seeing as they're in our allied attitude. We are fabricating a claim against them. Aragon is now at Naples. Okay. Alright, Aragon. Probably gonna kill you and take you for all you're worth when we rebuild Catalonia. But, sure. In fact, when is our truce up? We did take a pretty big peace deal, so 67. It's going to be a while. So we are going to have to think about what idea group we want to take soon. It's going to be a tough one. Let's go... Oh, that's so beautiful. I do love this. You could click on the map, or you could just click the obvious answer, which is Naples, Napoli. Okay. And actually, let's start now that we have that built. I believe we needed that. That will increase our trade power by a whole ton in Genoa. But now that we have that done, we are going to want to save up money for our institution. So we'll wait for that. Oh, they did give Cesari to Genoa. All right. It's too bad we couldn't take Cagliari, but that's all right. Let's look at our fleet, because we shouldn't have the whole thing... there's only one trade ship. I don't really care about that. Never mind, the whole thing will hunt pirates. I was thinking, you know, we could have our trade ships protecting trade, but... now that I think about it, I mean... No, I'd rather have them grouped up. Just so that if we do go to war and they are out at sea and I don't notice them, better to have that insurance policy of them all being together so that they can escape with relatively unscathed. But yeah, things are going pretty well this campaign. Got rid of the yoke of Aragon in one go. They're still independent, which is good for us. Although we will have to go to war with Castile eventually. But hopefully we can wait until we're no longer... until we have France on our side for that war. Okay, let's fabricate a claim on Ancona. Very nice. And why are you idle? You should be targeting France. Oh, but we already have improved relations plus 100. And here we have improved relations plus 100. Okay, that makes sense. And then the other one we will be putting towards the other diplomat. We will be putting towards, oh man, macro builder. There we go. Outrage countries. So ironically, we're improving relations with the papal state, but oh well. We do want them to not be angry with us. Let's go up to speed 4. Not too much going on right now. Kind of just waiting up for a next war. Let's see. You are at war with Provence. You're losing. And let's wait for our next claim, and then we'll see what we have. Austria is no longer considered a great power. We are actually, I mean, a bit far away, but we're getting there. Certainly better than we were. No, we need 25 to get Umbria. Looks like the Ottomans took a big chunk of Serbia, the southern half. And they took a bunch of Karaman. Interesting. Are you allied to the Ottomans? No, you're allied to the Mamluks. So they must have gone to the war at the same time. Ottomans are at war with Dalkadir, though they no longer have a core on that area. Of course we'll take the power. They no longer have a... They have a claim, but not a core on the Dalkadir earlier area. Of course, they'll always be able to get core it pretty easily, as there are Turkish Sunni. So it's pretty much perfect for them. Is Trebizond also a center of trade now? No. Sinop is. I don't know if that used to be a center of trade, but... And Damascus is. And that's Aleppo. Aleppo and Damascus are both centers of trade now. I think that's good. It's pretty historical. But yeah. So yeah, we're just kind of sitting. I will leave these forts on as they do provide devastation loss. Actually, it looks like our devastation has already gone down all the way. It's very nice. So it looks like prosperity will be able to slowly start building up. Very good. What does this do for us? Local development cost, okay. If it became prosperous, it would have local development cost, local goods produced, and monthly autonomy change. Okay. It's pretty good. I like the development cost. We might go for economic ideas first, just because I love that tech with the with our development cost minus 10%. I don't know, but we're going to lose that when we become Italy. It's a question. I don't know. Could also go military. It's tough. Influence would also be good to get that, I mostly like it because it, for the diplomatic reputation, aggressive expansion impact, and diplomatic annexation cost. Those are the big ones. Income from vassals, prestige, eh. Diplomatic relations is good. Vassal force limit and unjust hard advance is pretty good. So yeah, it's a pretty good one. Catalonia gains 10% liberty to desire. Yeah, we'll take that. Our statesman is dead. Let's get a new one. And are you winning against Provence? No, you are not. It's pretty sad there, Pope. Oh, let's, I should be fabricating a claim on Umbria. Man, I need to get better about doing that on time. And we'll fabricate a claim on Rome just in case we want it, but we probably won't. We probably will go Protestant so that we can take Rome without any penalties before we become Italy. Yeah, and plus I just like Protestant, but anyway. Alright, let's see. Will France come to your aid? Yes, they will. It's too bad. So we cannot do that yet. It would be very dangerous. We could fabricate on Genoa. I think our next war is going to be to make Catalonia stronger. So either on Spain, who's only allied with Portugal, would France join us? They would if we gave them land. Now that's intriguing. And Navarro is their vassal, okay. 13, 13. How many troops does Castile have? Country. Let's go with military. And Castile, you have 27,000. So they have more than France at the moment, despite France being pretty strong for the time period. Brittany took Anjou. But Provence won their war against the Pope. Very good. We like to see that. Little Vatican. I like how the little the smokestacks are in the middle of the Vatican thing at the bottom there. I don't know what it's called, but anyway. But yeah, we're just letting time go by. Getting waiting for that military attack, but we don't want to get tech until, well, it's present here. Okay, that's good. It's going at 0.89 a month. 1.6, so we'll let it spread a bit. Usually I take it as soon as possible. But could we even take it right now? Yes, we definitely could with 200. We could take a loan out and get it right now. But I think it's fine. We're going to wait for the tech. Wait for our power to go up a bit. Wait for it to spread. And then we'll spend less money on it. Especially Palermo, because that is a high development province. So therefore, it costs a lot to upgrade it without it spreading naturally. And we will not take the tech right now. Liberty desiring subjects. He's a malevolent. Alright, and now we need to think about this. Do we wish to hope for a better heir? He's 313. She's terrible as well. But he's... oh, it's just so bad. I mean, he's only one worse than us, but he's weak claim. I think we get rid of him. The aggressive expansion would be too much. No, we're gonna keep our prestige. It's too early in the game. It's a tough choice. You could go either way, but for now, I think we're gonna hold off. Savoy, would you want to be friends? Who else is allied to France? Scotland, Brittany, Naples, Brittany, huh? The Papal State, and Galbraith. Burgundy is allied to Brittany as well. Don't think that's going to last forever. But oh well. So it's the Age of Discovery. We could up our development, but I think we're going to wait on... ooh, but it would be so worth it. They paid off Bosnia's debt, alright. Who is at war with the Ottomans again? Ottomans are really going hard at the Balkans this game. Catalonia, just Catalonia has ended, okay. Great stuff. 67. Who else hates you, Castile? France and England. England, would you want to join in on a war? No, but you hate France, so therefore we can't be allies. It's too bad. And I think we are going to... we are going to go economic ideas, and I think we're going to go... yes, we'll absolutely pay for a court painter. For that increased stability. And I think we're going to start getting admin tech as soon as possible so that we can, when we get economic ideas, we can power through it. I just think that economic ideas, there's something about it that is just so good. Every single one of them, tax modifier, construction cost, yearly inflation, interest per annum is not great. Try not to take loans, but when you do take loans, it's totally worth it. Monthly autonomy change is nice. Land maintenance is nice. Production efficiency is okay. And development cost is amazing. So, I mean, it's just such a good idea group. mean, you could take religious, instead, and start taking when we take over Tunis. But I think we're gonna have to kill them a bunch first. It's gonna take a while to get. I think it's gonna take multiple wars to get the devastation up to 100. So anyway. So we might not even be expanding into Muslim territory for a while. Speaking of which, who are you allied to? You're allied to the Ottomans. That's going to be a tough war. Who are now in charge of most of the Balkans. Great. And your vassal, Dalgadir. Okay. Treasure is dead. Let's get yearly prestige. For sure. Very nice for the aggressive expansion. Milan, I'm sure, is attacking. Yep, attacking Switzerland, but this time they're for once failing. Well, the Milan's seeing you back. But anyway. Milan and Switzerland, for some reason, they always want to expand into each other. I mean, to be fair, Milan's a great province, especially now that it's an inland center of trade, but. Baronial revolts. I believe this is a unique event to Naples. The authority of King Ferrante of Naples has challenged twice during the two baronial revolts of 1459 to 1464 and 1485 to 1486. The revolts were in favor of the French pretenders to the throne, as King Ferrante pursued his policy of strengthening the royal authority in expense of the rights of barons. I am King of Naples. Or abdicate in favor of France forms a personal union. No. So we're going to take a stability hit. France is going to like us a little bit less. And 20 noble rebels in Messina. Okay, well, let's look at our force limit. Oh, okay. We can deal with this. So let's put that to the side. Build up some... let's build up mostly infantry. Maybe one cav. Let them build up. And it'll choose the first event whenever it's the first option after 3 months. So we'll just let time go by. Alright. Philosopher's dead. Man, we just paid for that guy. Alright, production efficiency, sure. Alright, we're going to go here, and then we're going to get the straight crossing and the mountains bonus when we attack, as we have this fort paid for. Okay, let's fire the event. Sorry to see you go, Prestige, and let's go and attack into the mountains. But they will be the ones- Whoa, what the heck? Oh my god, I forgot to increase my maintenance. How rookie of a mistake is that? Alright, let's go to... budget. Oh my god, I can't believe I did that. It's a little embarrassing. But you know, to be fair, I haven't been playing EU4 for a while. I have trouble playing EU4 when I know that there's an expansion coming out. Just because I find that, you know, I just want the expansion to be out already. So I generally tend to hope that it's, wait for it to come out, and then I start playing EU4 again. And he's taken over. Great. Well, this was a sad failure of a rebellion, but anti-rebellion, I guess you could call it. But so now we're going to take more losses, and that was a very painful mistake. But, you know, you make them. Lose some, get some. The good news is that we're not going to war for a while anyway, so. For another 7 years or so. So it's not like it's the worst thing in the world. We were at war with Castile. Castile declared war... Conquest Compass of Belly, okay. And we are going to need to take the tech soon, because we're going to reach our cap. Not yet. It is at 1092, so... we'll be fine for now, but eventually we are going to have to embrace the institution, which we are close to in money. Okay, let's go back to Napoli. We are sustaining quite the big army right now. Let's actually reduce maintenance again, even though it caused me to lose many men to the rebellion. But oh well, it is what it is. Construction costs, development costs, okay. Oh, that's the Renaissance. I thought he'd passed the first reform in the HRE, which I believe does the same thing. Construction cost, development cost, yeah. Alright, Castile is, of course, winning against Aragon. Be a broke, Castile. Give Catalonia some land. Now that would be funny. Cilion. Okay, and there's the first reform. Not surprising. They usually get the first reform done, and then the Reformation, maybe the second reform, and then the Reformation fires, and then they're screwed over for the rest of the game. Although with the I guess the diplomatic reputation objective, or whatever you want to call these rewards, isn't actually that good for maintaining it. So, oh well. Genoa has declared war on Aragon, probably for Cagliari. Okay. It's too bad we can't declare war on Aragon. Now would be the perfect time. Ooh, I want to take the tech so bad. 217 gold. How close is it to spreading to, say, Syracuse and Messina? Our other high development provinces, pretty close. So we'll be getting this very quickly. Is there a castle on Malta? No, there's not. I also was thinking about playing as Venice. Venice is a fun start. I was thinking of going to war against the Byzantines, vassalizing them, and hoping that doing the little trick where you go to war with the Byzantines, you ally Austria, and then you vassalize the Byzantines after the Ottomans have declared war, and then you get to fight a defensive war against the Ottomans with the Austrians on your side, and you get a nice early game where you have a vassal Byzantium, strong vassal Byzantium. It's a fun game, but oh well. Okay, hopefully Genoa takes none of this land. That would be very annoying. I'm surprised they didn't make Barcelona an important center for trade. I guess that would make the Genoa node a little bit too crowded in terms of centers. Bourgeoisie request privileges. Okay, we are going to lose the diplomatic power. Actually, wait a second. Okay, our cap has gone up. It's nice. We are going to, yes, lose with the bourgeoisie, with the burghers, and then we are going to go to the nobility and demand, let's call a diet first, and then demand military support, just to get our flagging military power up there. Honest merchants of Naples, very nice. Okay, Messina has been embraced it. Let's see. Is anyone else close to embracing? I mean, you're close. I think we're just going to pay for it, because we're at the cap, so let's do it. Alright, and then let's take the tech. And we're already, like, 3/4 of the way in administrative. Good. And let's go economic ideas, because I just love economic ideas as an opener. Tax modifier. Yeah, let's pay for one. And for military units, I like the I think I like the longbow, the balanced one. I go back and forth between that and the men-at-arms, but let's go with the longbow. I don't think we get... No, there's no special troops for Naples. That's too bad. Man, that was such a long truce time over there again. But they... Guaranteed by Castile. Not cool. More local recruiting. Oh, and that's the other reason I love an economic ideas. You just get random, random little development. Just for free. No reason. Just... You know, they just want to reward you. And it looks like Castile took most of Aragon. And Genoa has taken the Italian islands. Alright. So I think it's about time that we do go to war with Castile. They're still probably just allied with Portugal. France is much stronger now. So yeah, I think we go to war for the cause of Catalonia. And yeah, I think that'd be great. Let's go for Tarragona. There we go. Do we want to call in? No. We do want to call in France, and we'll give you Northern. Everything that's not in the Genoa node, we're fine with you having. Right. Let's go to war. See if this works out. Immediately. I always forget about the navies. Because, you know, it's just so easy to forget. But anyway. Let's get our morale up. Oh, well, it's gonna go down to half anyways, so let's just go and get on and go to yeah, I think we can go by. He does have his transports there. And he has some rebels in Granada, so now is like the perfect time to go to war. Chance point 7 men. And France is dealing with his navy. Very nice. Let's go over again. Can we get there just through military access? No. We could now for once do this. Say you guys go over there. Let's see if it works. This is gonna be awesome, if it works. Are you guys in dock? Yes, you did. Good job. I am impressed, Paradox. Thank you. He's going over. And it looks like Castile just suicided his. Oh, he didn't suicide. He won the fight, but he just lost tons of men to the Granadan rebels. Good to see, good to see. Peasants' War. All right, and all of our men are over here. Nice. Let's go and siege down Alicante. We will see Catalonia under Italian yoke. Called for a crusade against the Ottomans, not surprising. Let's transfer that to Catalonia. And let's siege down Jaén. This is a little risky. How close are you? Minus 14%. All right. I'm pretty sure he's gonna stay there until then. So let's just continue sieging. What do you want from Castile, by the way? You still want the Baleares, but anyway, what do you want? Do you want all of that? Okay, fine with giving you that. Burgers lose loyalty or we lose money. Yeah, we'll take the loan. National tax modifier, nice. Portugal has no idea what he's doing. Just kind of walking around like a chicken with its head cut off. But alright. Good job getting that siege done, France. Always good to have France as an ally. So easy early game. And he stacked like the Castilian stack. Very good. And would you give me that? Yes, you would, but France would not be happy with that. Cannot be selected because France does not want it. What do you want, France? Would France be okay with this? No, he would not. He would decidedly be not okay with this. So let's continue sieging. See what he wants. Maybe he just wants Navarre as well? We'll go siege that down as soon as we're done with this. The siege. Catalonia doing, you know, dumb vassal things. We will not take any ahead of time penalty. If we can help it. We are slowly, slowly sieging Jane. I'm sure I'm pronouncing that terribly. It's like Jayan. Oh well. And looks like Castile just destroyed France's army, so that's not good. We'll be fine. Maybe we'll go down to speed 3 while we're sieging. Okay, come on, take it. Oh, come on. Troops, we cannot let him take that. That'd be decidedly bad. Come on. 57%. Luck be a lady. There we go. Alright. Now we will go north to Navarra. Actually, we'll go to Soria. Because I'm pretty sure he won't leave this one while he's has it sieged. But he will leave it because of that. Because I'm coming. Alright. Alright, France. What do you want? Okay, France does want that. Okay. And they probably just want... Yeah, they want these ones, but they did... For some reason, it didn't let them want it because unless they have a land bridge. Strange. Maybe the AI is getting smarter. But either way, we need to siege this back for France. France, why don't you, not attack? No, that's a bad idea. Come on, France. Alright, we're gonna leave one behind. Nope. Okay. He's gonna do this little dance, probably. Nope, he's locked in. Okay. Let's select you. No, we're not gonna attack into the hills. We're gonna go around and fight in the grasslands with France. He does have his full army going there, so maybe this will be a good fight. The Plight of Calabria. Famine, refused aid, or 16 ducats. Yeah, we'll pay the 16 ducats. Let's give this to France. And you go to Catabria. And this fight looks like it's going well. Very nice. Go to Catabria as well. And we will give France all the land that he wants. And we will peace out. Hopefully very soon. So yeah, things have been going pretty swimmingly. Oh, but we are way over time. So let's end this war in this episode. And then we'll call it quits. So let's see. This guy, France is still unhappy by 6. And they don't want anything else. Do they want, like, Soria? And we'll let them siege this down first. Okay, they do want maybe that. No. Do they want Riorja? Nope. So what the heck do they want? Alright, I think we're gonna have to take the trusted. So let's just, when the AI starts going like this. Well, let's see. Maybe they want Asturias? Maybe this is what's going wrong. I don't know, the AI is being a little wonky right now. As far as what they want. Because it says that it wants this entire coastline, but it's showing it that it wants the, its actions are contrary to that. It does have 9 pretender rebels back home. Okay, France. Now's the time. Nope. Alright, we're just gonna have to take the relations hit. But alright, we're going to give a ton of land back to Catalonia. France will be angry, but not by too much. I think he will stay in the alliance, which is nice. And yeah, let's take as much money as we can get from you. That you were willing to give us, okay. It's kind of hard to see exactly how much money he'll give. Not much. Okay, 30 ducats. Sure, we'll take it. And yeah, I think we're good with that. Let's peace out. And that's the end of the war. So, second major war won. We are doing pretty well in this campaign. We have a strong vassal over here. Naples is doing well. Prosperity is increasing. So, yeah. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time. Like, comment, subscribe. It's a new series, so it really helps make the channel grow. Makes it more available in the YouTube search. And, yeah. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time.